하늘을 달리다. 오늘은 조비 항공서비스 소프트웨어 FAA 승인 소식 관련하여 전달드리도록 하겠습니다. 이번 영상은 새롭게 업데이트된 소식을 제가 전달드림과 함께 조비에서 직접 이번 소프트웨어 승인에 대한 의의를 밝힌 인터뷰를 공유해드리려고 하니 조비 투자자께서는 꼭 시청 부탁드립니다. 그럼 시작하겠습니다. 조비는 6월 20일 발표를 통해 최근 FAA로부터 자사에서 개발한 소프트웨어 도구 모음인 엘리베이트 OS의 사용 승인을 받았다고 발표했습니다. 이 소프트웨어는 조비의 2025년 상업용 에어택시 서비스 운영을 위해 개발되었는데요. 조종사 툴, 일정 관리, 모바일 우선 라이드 앱, 그리고 지능형 매칭 엔진 등 서비스 운영에 필요한 전반적인 시스템이 공식 승인받았다고 보시면 될것 같습니다. 특히 주목할 만한 기능은 지능형 매칭 엔진인데, 우버나 카카오택시 같은 호출앱 방식과 유사하게 승객을 이용 가능한 항공기 및 착륙 인프라와 매칭시켜 효율성 높은 서비스를 제공한다고 합니다. 이러한 방식은 조비가 2021년 우버의 에어택시 부분인 우버 엘리베이터를 인수한 영향이 크다고 볼수 있는데요. 우버 엘리베이터는 이미 2019년 뉴욕시에서 헬리콥터를 우버 앱으로 호출해서 사용하는 우버콥터를 출시해 운영한 바 있습니다. 조비는 이번 엘리베이터 OS 개발을 위해 2년 전부터 내부적으로 여러 준비를 했다고 밝혔는데요. 앱을 통해 탑승 시간과 출발지, 목적지를 자유롭게 선택해서 항공편을 결제 예약할 수 있는 실제 서비스를 개발해 왔고, 비슷한 경로를 이용하고자 하는 승객들을 매칭시키는 AI 매칭 엔진을 자동화해 왔다고 합니다. 또한 조종사 앱이나 운영 소프트웨어 같은 서비스에 필요한 통합 작업도 테스팅했다고 전했는데요. 단순히 한두 개의 소프트웨어를 개발한 것이 아닌 에어택시 사업에 필요한 전반적인 소프트웨어 요소를 모두 개발한 것이기 때문에 꽤나 큰 진전을 이뤘다고 볼수 있을 것 같습니다. 그럼 이런 내용에 대해 조비의 최고 제품 책임자인 에릭 알리손이 설명한 인터뷰를 보실 텐데요. 엘리베이터 OS가 실제 구동되는 화면과 함께 어떤 고민과 과정을 거쳐 개발했는지 상세히 설명하는 만큼 주의 깊게 봐주셨으면 좋겠습니다. 그럼 영상 보겠습니다.
At Joby, we think about our software as needing to be like the central nervous system in our bodies. It needs to deliver real-time communications between all of the various parts of our operation while making sure that they all work coherently together, an operating system for our operations. During my time at Uber, we ran high-tempo air taxi operations in New York City, and we quickly learned that software like this just didn't exist. Even the most sophisticated helicopter operators relied on systems and FAA-approved manuals and procedures designed for a different purpose in a different era. Connecting to Uber, while seamless on the surface, required a dance of phone calls and emails and even hard copy printouts to stay compliant with approved procedures. In a similar vein, booking a privately chartered aircraft today is remarkably inefficient. It typically requires several rounds of emails or calls just to get a price quote. We knew that to achieve the type of on-demand multimodal trips we want to deliver, we'd have to do things very differently. So we started to build the tools that would bring that ultra-responsive central nervous system to life, distilling what we are learning at Uber into an Elevate OS, or operating system. In 2021, Joby acquired Uber Elevate and brought on board critical members of the original team. Since then, we've grown the team and built out the idea of Elevate OS, this time with the added benefit of doing it right alongside the team that's developing our air taxi operations, allowing us to perfect both sides of the equation. The operating system we have developed includes an electronic flight bag for the pilot that allows them to complete their pre-flight and post-flight checks, informs them about the passengers and the weight and balance of the aircraft, and contains their duty assignments and logbook, both of which will be automatically populated via our flight planning system. There's also an operations core which manages aircraft and pilot availability, plans routes, maintenance, and landing pad access. Then, there's a mobile-first rider app, which is the passenger interface, allowing people to book and pay for flights and allowing us to integrate with our partners, Uber and Delta in the U.S., and other partners internationally. And finally, there's an intelligent matching engine that sits behind all this and brings it together, connecting a passenger with an aircraft, a landing pad, a pilot, and a route, all in the blink of an eye, versus the hours or days it takes to organize a charter aircraft today. The really great thing is that Elevate OS brings together a range of world-class capabilities into one system, while still allowing us to add best-in-class third-party applications where that makes the most sense. And as we've developed the system, we've learned several important things. First, and this might sound obvious, but all those pieces have to be able to speak to each other. They have to be built in the same architecture with the same language and the same intent in order for them to be able to deliver the flexibility and the speed we're looking for. That's why we are building an operating system that spans across all of our operations, not just a grab bag of tools. There are many great examples in both the automotive and the airline worlds where new and legacy software tools have failed to work well together, leading to operational chaos. Next, we learned that there are significant benefits when you do build these systems together. And one great example of that is maintenance. In a rudimentary form, the system can start to demonstrate intelligence, identifying when an aircraft won't be available due to scheduled maintenance. But as that system matures and learns about the real-time performance of the aircraft, it can start to predict maintenance requirements, helping to reduce downtime and improve safety. And of course, it's constantly learning about the performance of our aircraft, drawing data from the entire fleet. And finally, we've seen the remarkable value of having our software team work hand in glove with our operations team, co-designing our processes and our software for the very best performance and customer experience. Something you just can't do if you're not building both parts yourself. Since Joby's acquisition of Elevate, we've constantly improved, tested, and iterated this software. And in fact, some of these tools are already on their third full iteration. And with that experience, it's abundantly clear to us that it is just not feasible to pick up an air taxi and drop it into an existing airline operation. A few years ago, a book came out on the history of Amazon, The Everything Store by Brad Stone. One of the things that struck me was that Amazon was able to launch Amazon Prime and redefine the way we think about buying online precisely because it had built a custom software foundation to manage its operation, allowing Amazon to operate at a speed and scale no legacy system could come close to matching. We'd think about our software in a similar way. And since being awarded that Part 135 certificate more than 2 years ago, we've had the opportunity to gain incredibly valuable experience running the software we've built in a real-life environment. We've successfully operated a true on-demand rider app. We used our Cirrus aircraft to simulate the Joby rider experience, letting our team members book flights using our rider app, giving them free choice of timing, origin, and destination within the range of the aircraft. We used automation tools to match team members to aircraft and other team members with similar plans to each other. By October of last year, we were using the pilot app, the rider app, and our operations core in tandem with one another and successfully processing payments for our flights, all with our own software, including for external customers booking our Cirrus SR22 for charter flights. In other words, we were already running software today that is much more efficient than anything you can buy off the shelf for Part 135 operations. We still have plenty to do, but the experience we are gaining is critically important for us and something that really sets Joby apart. As we look ahead, we'll continue to run and iterate our software in an FAA-compliant manner, and we look forward to sharing more about our operating system and the various apps we are developing as we approach commercial service.
오늘 발표 이후 주가는 첫날 기대와 다르게 -4%가 빠진 이후 그 다음날 8%가 다시 상승하는 흐름을 보여주었는데요. 발표 내용이 좋았음에도 첫날은 공매도 비율 상승과 파생 만기가 겹치는 내만여의 날 이슈 등으로 하락한 것으로 보여집니다. 그리고 다음날 아처 에비에이션이 샌프란시스코 지역 5개 항공 네트워크 구축을 발표하면서 아처는 17%, 조비는 8% 각각 크게 상승하는 흐름을 보여주었는데 현재 시장을 이끌고 있는 엔비디아 같은 주종목이 하락하는 와중에 UAM 섹터가 크게 상승했기 때문에 상당히 의미 있는 날이었다고 생각합니다. 앞으로도 지속적인 개발 과정이 성공적으로 이루어지면서 꾸준히 상승이 이루어지길 기대해보겠습니다. 오늘은 조비의 항공 서비스 소프트웨어인 엘리베이트 OS의 FAA 승인 소식에 대해 알아보았습니다. 개발 소식만 접하면서 막연한 기대를 했던 과거와 달리 에어택시 사업이 정말 상용화될 수 있을 것 같은 기대감이 드는 소식이었는데요. 이날 발표에서 소프트웨어에 대한 내용 이외에도 중요한 정보가 많았던 만큼 다음 시간에 이에 대한 추가적인 내용을 전달드리도록 하겠습니다. 궁금하시거나 알아보고 싶은 내용이 있다면 댓글로 남겨주세요. 감사합니다.